हेलो गाइस, एलके त्रिपाठी इज हियर। स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग अबाउट चैप्टर 6, दैट इज हिस्ट्री, ट्रेड एंड टाउन्स। इन द कंसर्न ऑफ द न्यू वीडियो वी शैल वॉच ए क्लोजर लुक एट 3 सिटीज। फर्स्ट दैट इज हम्पी। हम्पी वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सिटी ऑफ द मेडिवल पीरियड। इट वॉज द कैपिटल सिटी ऑफ विजयनगर, विच वॉज नोन ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सिटी ऑफ द पीरियड। नाउ लेट्स बिगिन इट। ये ग्रैंड कैपिटल सिटी हम्पी इज लोकेटेड ऑन द बैंक्स ऑफ द रिवर तुंगभद्रा इन नॉर्दर्न कर्नाटका। द नेम हम्पी इज एन एंग्लिसाइज वर्जन ऑफ कन्नड़ा वर्ड हम्पे, derived from Pampa, the ancient name of river Tungbhadra. Hampi is the ancient name of river Tungbhadra. It is an anglicized, means एक जो है दैवी वर्जन है, ये कन्नड़ भाषा का हम्पे से ही हम्पी बना हुआ है। Tungbhadra river is very holy river of that region, so this city got its name based on the river Tungbhadra. Hampi stands among the ruins of Vijayanagar, the former capital of the Vijayanagar Empire. In northern Karnataka, it is also referred to as Virupakshapura after the name of the patron deity of the Vijayanagara rulers Virupaksha. It was named after the patron deity of Vijayanagara rulers Virupaksha. Vijayanagara in this way came into the prominence in northern Karnataka. The empire was founded by the Telugu princes Harihara and Bukka in 1336. Two sisters were there and their name it raised its side. इस एम्पायर का नाम तेलुगु प्रिंसेस जो दो थी बहनें हरिहरा और बुक्का के नाम पर ही पड़ा हुआ है 1336 सेंचुरी में। इट रीज द हाइट ऑफ इट्स ग्लोरी अंडर कृष्णदेवराय। कृष्णदेवराय बिकेम वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रूलर ऑफ दिस डायनेस्टी। इन हिज रेन दिस सिटी इज एट इट्स हाइट। हम्पी वॉज चूजन एज द कैपिटल ड्यू टू इट्स स्ट्रेटजिक लोकेशन बाउंड बाय द रिवर तुंगभद्रा ऑन वन साइड एंड द डिफेंसिव हिल्स ऑन द अदर साइड। Foreign travelers like Niccolo Conti from Italy, Abdul Razzaq from Persia and Domingo Pais from Portugal visited Vijayanagara and described the city as well fortified with a distinctive architecture. Foreign traveler Niccolo Conti from Italy described about this nagar beautifully. Abdul Razzaq, Persian visitor, and Domingo Pais, Portuguese visitor, they all described about the Vijayanagar, which was well fortified with a distinctive architecture. The buildings had splendid arches, domes and pillared halls, well-planned orchards and pleasure gardens with sculpture motifs such as the lotus were also built. The account of Domingo Pais, who visited the court of Krishnadevaraya, is particularly unique as it provides a vivid account of the Vijayanagara Empire. complete and very lengthy information about the Vijayanagar is received by the Domingo Pace. Besides beautiful palaces, there were many temples in the city, including the Vitthalaswami and Virupaksha temples. The temples were the hub of cultural activities and devadasis, that is, temple dances performed before the deity, the royalty, and the masses. Remains of rows of shops or either side of the road leading to the Virupaksha temple suggests that the temple was a center of commerce as well. According to Abdul Razzaq, a huge tank was built with the help of Portuguese mason. Channels were constructed to supply water from the tank to different parts of the city. Vijayanagara enjoyed voluminous maritime trade with several countries and regions such as Persia, Arabia, Africa, the Malayan Archipelago, Burma, China, and numerous islands in the Indian Ocean region. Hampi controlled the internal trade on the Indian Peninsula, except for a few principalities along the Malabar coast. The empire was well known as an important center of textile industry, mining, metalwork, and agricultural products. The main articles of export were gold, spices such as cardamom and pepper, and precious stones. Jewels, spices, cotton, ivory, semi-precious stones, and perfumes were the main items of trade with China. The articles of import were saffron, coral, knives, rose, water, quicksilver, and vermilion. Masulipatnam now. Masulipatnam or Maslipatnam is a city on the Coromandel coast of Andhra Pradesh in India. The city derives its name from a gateway to the town decorated with the eyes of a fish. It was founded in the 14th century by Arab traders who founded their way from the Red Sea to southern India. The towns became a center of international trade and commerce for the Dutch, the English, and the French. The Dutch had established a factory at Masulipatnam after receiving a farman from the Qutub Shahi rulers. The English East India Company had set up its first trading post here in 1611 century. However, during the Carnatic Wars, they lost the port city temporarily to the French. The British conquered it again, along with the northern Syracuse, in 1759 century. In the beginning, Masulipatnam traded with countries like Indonesia, Thailand, and Malaysia. The establishment of a sea link with the Arab countries led to the expansion of trade, which proved advantageous for the port town. Masulipatnam evolved as a center where weaving and dyeing industries flourished. The articles of trade comprised chains, muslin and diamonds. The port center was famous for its kalamkari, textiles and prints, which were created by painting designs in colored dyes onto the cloth using a bamboo kalam. Kalamkari cloth had a ready market in West Asia and Europe. Under the Mughals, Masulipatnam handled a lot of trade among different regions of India. For example, tobacco and dyed cotton textiles were transported from Masulipatnam to Bengal, and large amount of indigo were transported from Bengal to Masulipatnam. Next, that is Surat. About this topic, we shall be discussing in coming videos. Before that, you prepare all such topics in proper way, get the questions and important lines and exact answers required from you. We shall be meeting next day with a new video. We will be discussing properly about the chapter, rest part of the chapter. Till then, thank you.